the Evil Genie. Biff had an idea. She wanted to try an experiment. So one day, she put a bottle over a tiny apple. I wonder if the apple will grow in the bottle, she thought. I'll have to wait and see. After a long, long time, Biff went to see if the experiment was working. It was. In the bottle was a big apple. Biff showed the bottle to Nadim. When he saw the apple, he was amazed. How did you get that in there? He asked. Suddenly, the magic key began to glow. The magic took the children into another adventure. I wonder where the magic is taking us, called Kibber. The magic took them to a tiny island in the middle of the ocean. Fluffy hated magic adventures. Oh no, he groaned. We're on the bare island with only one tree in the middle. Why have you come here? Asked Biff. Maybe there is a reason why the magic has brought us here, said Nadim. But what? Moaned Kibber. There's nothing here. No, I don't like the look of this, said Biff. This is not going to be a good adventure. Help me climb the tree, said Nadim. And maybe I can see the chip going past. Biff saw the bottle sticking out of the sand. It was tied to the base of the tree. How strange, thought Biff. She untied the bottle and picked it up. Suddenly, Nadim began to wave and shout. I can see a boat, he called, but it's a long way off. They all waved and shouted. The boat turned and came towards them. Hooray, it's coming, yelled Kibber. The boat reached the island. There was a boy sailing it. What are you doing on this tiny island? He asked. You wouldn't believe us even if he told you, said Biff. The boy said he was to rescue them, so they all climbed into the boat. I hate boats, thought Fluffy. Biff took the bottle with her. It's very heavy, she said. I wonder what's in it. The boy sailed the boat away from the island. My name is Kimer, he said. I am the son of Hassan the Explorer. Why are you all by yourself? Asked Nadim. I'm looking for my father, said Kimer. He has been missing for 4 years. Biff showed Kimer the bottle she had found on the island. It's a very strange looking bottle, she said. I found it on the island. There's something heavy inside, said Kimer. Let's open it. Kimer pulled a cork out of the bottle. Then something terrible happened. There was a loud bang and a cloud of smoke. An evil genie shot out. There was a terrible smell like rotten eggs. Oh, gasped Biff. What have you done? Ha, I am free at last, shouted the genie. You will be sorry to let me out. Why? Asked Biff. You should be thankful. Not me, cried the genie. I hate all people, but most of all, I hate the man who put me in this bottle. His name is Hassan, cried the genie, and now I am off to deal with him. Then the genie grew very big. First, I will deal with you, he said. He puffed out his cheeks and blew very hard. Help, called Kimer. He's making a storm. The wind snapped up the mask. Big waves tossed the boat up and down. Hang on, everyone, yelled Kimer. We're being blown onto a big island. Biff said this wasn't going to be a good adventure, shouted Kibber. The boat was swept onto the shore. It hit some rocks and turned over. They were all thrown onto the beach. Then the storm stopped. Biff and Nadim looked around. They were all wet, but nobody was hurt. Everyone looked at the boat. There was a big hole in the bottom. If we can mend this hole, said Kimer, we will be stuck on this island. Things are getting worse, thought Fluffy. There are too many flies here. Then they saw a man running towards them. He had a long black beard and long hair. It was Kamer's father, Hassan. When Kamer saw him, he shouted, "Father, it is you? I am your son, Kamer." Hassan gave Kamer a hug. Hassan told them that his ship has been wrecked on the island. I live in a hut made of a bit of wood. I have been alone for 4 years, he said. Then I will take you home, said Kamer. All we have to do is mend my boat. Kamer's father showed them a big chest. It was washed up in the storm, he said. It may be full of treasure, but I can't open it. I don't have a key. Let him look at the chest. It would need a special key to open it, he said. Suddenly, there was a whooshing sound and a terrible smell of rotten eggs. The Evil Genie appeared. His voice sounded like thunder. Aha! He shouted. You trapped me in the bottle. Now I will deal with you, Hassan. Floppy hated the adventure, and he hated the genie even more. He began to bark and snarl at the genie. Floppy, called Biff, don't do it. But Floppy barked even more. Help, cried the genie. I hate dogs. The genie flew away. Hooray, shouted Kipper. Good riddance to the horrid, smelly old genie. Hassan looked upset. But how did he escape? He asked. I put him in a bottle years ago. Hassan told them about the genie. He can't touch him himself, but he can get other things to hurt you. Like the way he made a storm, asked Biff. Yes, said Hassan, but he can only do 2 bad things a day. On the island was a mountain. On top of it lived a large bird. The genie flew up to where the bird lived. Now I will deal with that stupid dog, he said. He used his powers on the bird. Get the dog, he called. The bird flew down from the mountain. They felt cold wind from the beating wings. Quickly, yelled Hassan, get inside the hut. Floppy was frightened of the bird. He ran away from the hut. Floppy, come back, yelled Biff. The bird swooped onto the beach. It picked up Floppy on its claws. Biff, Nadim, and Kipper ran out of the hut. But the bird flew off with Floppy. Floppy, yelled Kipper. This is terrible, said Kipper. We'll have to rescue Floppy. This must be because of Genie, said Nadim. We'll have to get him back into a bottle. There must be a way to do it, said Biff. If only we knew what it was. Suddenly, the magic key began to glow. Oh, stop, called Nadim. We can't go now. We haven't rescued Floppy. The magic began to take them home. Don't glow, magic key, cried Biff. We can't leave Floppy behind. The magic took the children home. What can we do about Floppy? Asked Kipper. We can't leave him stuck in an adventure. Can we make the key take us back? He said, nodding. How? Asked Biff. We can never make it glow. It only glows when it wants to. Just then, Mom came into Biff's room. It's time for Nadim to go home, she said, and it's time for Kipper's bath. Kipper didn't want a bath, and Nadim didn't want to go home. They wanted to go back into that adventure. What's up, Biff? Asked Chip. You look upset. Biff told Chip about Floppy. We must go back and rescue him, said Chip. We've got to find a way to get the genie back into the bottle. If only the magic key would glow, said Biff.